Whenever you're building complex pipelines in PySpark, you often want to use code that you've written somewhere else. So instead of just copy-pasting it, you often want to package it as a library and read from another project or repository. So let me show you how you can package code in a library inside Foundry so that you can later on reuse it across multiple different projects. We are inside an aviation project, and we discovered duplicated code between the operation management and the flight control system. If we open the flight control system, we can see that there are functions used in the cleaning that are also present in the operations management repo. Let me show you. Inside the Python transforms, there is also a cleaner that contains the same code. Here, in highlight, let's extract these into a library that we will create. For this, let's go back to our root folder and open the shared resources folder that's inside. So going back, shared resources. And here, we're going to create a new folder. Let's give it the name of Aviation Cleaning Library. Aviation Cleaning Library. Inside, we also want to create a repository for our Python code. As you can see, there are multiple different options, but for now, we just want a repository. Let's call it also Aviation Cleaning Library, just like the folder. We also want the repository to be of the type Python Library. We confirm the name, it's what we want, and we hit Initialize Repository. As you can see, we now have an empty Python project. This will be where our library will live. Opening the README provides extra instructions on how to consume and publish a library. We are interested in the first part, how to publish a Conda library. The build.gradle file, it's a hidden configuration file. To show it, you can toggle Show Hidden Files and Folders. Now, going back to the README file, the README also tells us that we need to tag the repository to publish. Let's do that later. For now, let's set up the library structure. The MyProject folder under source is the root folder for your package. This is not a good name, so let's change it to something more meaningful, like cleaner. Inside the cleaner package, we'll create a new file called function.py. This is where our initial code is going to live. Since this is just an example, we're going to be using just a single file, but you could have other files and packages inside your source folder, like any Python library. Now that we wrote our function name, let's hit create, and let's copy the function from our code base into the new library. This function uses iterTools, so let's also import that. Import iterTools, and the red error line should go away. The green error, it's also just a linter, and simple linter makes it go away as well. Let's commit it and wait for the checks to pass. So after we commit, we trigger checks, which you can see here. Once they have succeeded, we can open them. Afterwards, we can open the log messages for library publish and search for Conda library publish message. Here we found it, and it says that it skipped. It also gives us more information saying that to publish the library, we need to actually create a tag on this branch under the commit. Let's do that. Next to codes, you find a tab called branches. Inside the branches, you have tags, which contains our tagging mechanism. Let's release this with a minor version of 0.1. We create the tag, and the release mechanism will trigger. So hitting it, you can now see that the tag got created. And Foundry is publishing the Python library for you. Once it says passed, you have now a library available. You can see the checks passed. You can also read through it if you want. But we confirm that our library is now published. With this, we have now created and published the Python library. In the description below, you'll also find another video which explains how to consume this library. Thank you for listening, and see you soon.